Hi, welcome back. In this video, we will understand how to apply a priori algorithm to find the association rules for the given set of transactions. This is the solved example number 3. The link for other videos is given in the description below. This is the dataset given to us. There are 9 transactions. In each transactions, a few of the items were bought. For example, in the first transactions, I1, I2 and I5 were bought. In the second transaction, I2 and I4 were bought. Similarly, in different transactions, different set of items were bought. Now, we need to apply the association rule mining, that is a priori algorithm, to get the association rules with the minimum support of 2 and confidence of 50%. Next, what we need to do is, we need to apply the bottom-up approach of a priori algorithm, where first we need to identify the 1 item sets. In this case, we have 5 unique items, that is I1, I2, I3, I4 and I5. Next, we need to find the frequency of each item. In this case, if we count I1, I1 is bought 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 times. So that is 6 is written here. Similarly, we need to count the frequency of the remaining items and then we need to write over here. Once you write the frequency of 1 item sets, next we need to identify the frequent 1 item set. A frequent 1 item set is the item set whose support is greater than or equal to minimum support. In this case, the minimum support given to us is 2. So all these 5 1 item sets qualify for frequent 1 item sets. So all of them are present in frequent 1 item set. Now we need to go for the next one, that is 2 item sets at a time. So from these 5 frequent 1 item sets, we need to write 2 frequent 2 item sets at a time. That is I1, I2, I1, I3, I1, I4, I1, I5, I2, I3, I4, I2, I4, I2, I5, I3, I4, I3, I5 and finally I4, I5 here. So there are 10 possibilities are there. So for those particular 10 possibilities, we need to identify the frequency here. For example, how many number of times I1 and I2 were bought? If you count I1 and I2, I1 and I2 is bought first time here, second time over here, and then third time here, fourth time over here. Similarly, I will take one more example, I2 and I3. I2, I3 is this one first time, second time, third time and fourth time. So I2, I3 is bought 4 times. So this is how we need to calculate the frequency of 2 item sets at a time. After that, we need to write all those 2 item sets whose frequency is greater than or equal to 2, that is the minimum support. In this case, we will get 6 such 2 item sets. Those are called as frequent 2 item sets. So in this case, the 6 frequent 2 item sets are I1, I2, I1, I3, I1, I5, I2, I3, I2, I4 and I2, I5 here. And the frequency is written in this case. Once you do this thing, the next step is to identify the 3 item sets. So if you want to identify the 3 item sets, the very first thing we need to know is unique items in frequent 2 item sets. So if you count the unique items, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, these are the unique items are there. From these particular 5 items, we need to write the three item sets first. That is I1, I2, I3, I1, I2, I4, I1, I2, I5. Now we have done with I1, next we'll start with I2. I2, I3, I4, I2, I3, I5. And then next one is I3 onwards, that is I3, I4, I5 here. So totally we will get 10 possibilities. Now, using these 5 items, we need to write the 3 item sets, that is I1, I2, I3, that is the first one, I1, I2, I4 is the second one, I1, I2, I5 is the next one, next I1, I3, I4, I1, I3, I5, I1, I4, I5, totally 6 possibilities are there with respect to I1. Next, we will start with I2, I2, I3, I4. I2, I3, I5, I2, I4, I5. There are 3 possibilities. And the final possibility is I3, I4, I5. So we have written all those possibilities here. Next, we need to find the frequency of those possibilities. For example, I1, I2, I3. We need to count it like I1, I2, I3 is present here, I1, I2, I3 is present. So it is present two times. Similarly, you need to identify the frequency of all these three item sets. Once you are done, we need to write all those item sets whose frequency is two or more. In this case, we have only two, that is I1, I2, I3, I1, I2, I5 here. Now, from these two frequent three item sets, we need to write the frequent four item sets if possible. The unique items are I1, I2, I3, I5. This is the only possible four item set and its frequency is one here. So this will not be the frequent item set because the minimum frequency required is two here. So we can say that these two are the frequent item sets in this case. I1, I2, I3 and I1, I2. I5 in this case. Now we need to write the association rules based on the frequent item set, minimum support and the minimum confidence. We got two frequent three item sets. The first one is I1, I2, I3. I have written 1, 2, 3 for representation purpose. And one more is I1, I2, I5. I have written I1, 1, 2 and 5 for representation. The minimum support is given is 2, so 2 by 9 is equivalent to 22.22%, that is the expected one, and the minimum confidence expected is 50% here. So if you want to write the association rules, the very first thing we need to do is we need to find the non-empty subsets except the same set. So in this case, the non-empty subsets of first one are set containing 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3. Similarly, the next one, 1, 2, 5, 1, 2, 1, 5, and then 2, 5. From these non-empty subsets, we can write the association rules using this particular formulae. That is, for every non-empty subset S tends to I minus S. This is a valid rule given the support of I, that is the frequent item set divided by support of S is greater than or equal to minimum confidence here. So S is the subset, remaining everything should be written on the right hand side here. So we will try to consider one frequent item set at a time and then we will try to write the rules. Now we will consider the first frequent item set, that is 1, 2, 3. The possible subsets, non-empty subsets are written here and their frequency is also written here. We have already found the frequencies, the same frequencies are written in this case. They are required for writing the calculating the confidence in this case. So the first rule is we will start with the first subset, that is 1, and remaining 2, 3 is written on the right hand side. We need to calculate these two things. So support of this is the number of times 1, 2, 3 is bought. The number of time 1, 2, 3 is bought is 2 times divided by 9, that is equal to 22.22%. The support is 22.22%. The confidence is equivalent to support of 1, 2, 3 divided by support of this one, that is 1. Support of 1, 2, 3 is 2 by 9. Support of 1 is, you can see here 6, 6 divided by 9, which is equivalent to 2 by 6. 33.34 is less than 50%. It's an invalid rule. Rule number 2, we'll start with the second subset, that is 2. The remaining is 1, 3 on the right hand side. Again, the support will be 22.22%. No need to calculate it. And the confidence is equivalent to support of 1, 2, 3 divided by support of this side, that is 2. 2 by 9 is the support of 1, 2, 3. Support of 2 is, it is bought 7 times, 7 divided by 9, which is equivalent to 2 by 7 equals to 28.57, which is less than 50% in this case. Again, it is an invalid rule. Coming back to the third rule, 3 is taken on the left hand side, remaining 1, 2 on the right hand side. Support is same. But the confidence is support of 1, 2, 3 divided by support of 3. 2 by 9 divided by 6 by 9 because I3 was bought 6 times, which is equivalent to 2 by 6, which is equivalent to 33.33%, less than 50%, hence it's an invalid rule. Rule number 4, we start with the next subset, that is 1, 2, the remaining is 3, support is 22.22% and confidence is support of 1, 2, 3 divided by support of 1, 2. 1, 2 is bought 4 times, so 2 by 9 divided by 4 by 9 is the confidence here, which is equivalent to 2 by 4, equals to 50%, that is equal to 50%, hence it is a valid rule. Now we will write the next rule. We will start with the next subset, that is 1, 3. The remaining is 2. The support in this case is again 22.22%. The confidence is equivalent to support of 1, 2, 3 divided by support of 1, 3. That is equivalent to 2/9 divided by 4/9, because 4 times 1 and 3 were put. So it is equivalent to 2/4, which is equivalent to 50%, which is equivalent to 50%, hence it is a valid rule. Coming back to the last rule, that is 2, 3, tends to 1, that is the last subset is 2, 3 here. Support is again 22.22%, but confidence is equivalent to support of 1, 2, 3 divided by support of 2, 3. 2/9 divided by 4/9, because 4 times I2 and I3 were brought together. So 2/4 is equivalent to 50%, hence it is a valid rule again. So in this case, we wrote 6 rules. Out of that, first, second and third were invalid rules, and fourth, fifth and sixth were valid or strong rules in this case. Back to the next one. The item set is 1 to 5. Whose possible subsets are written here, that is a non-empty subsets except the same set, and the their frequency is written over here. Now the first rule is, the first subset is 1 tends to the remaining, that is 2, 5. We need to calculate support and confidence. In this case, the support of 1 to 5 is 2/9 again, because the frequency of 1 to 5 is 2 divided by 9, that is equivalent to 22.22%. Confidence of this rule, that is 1 tends to 2, 5, is support of 1 to 5 divided by support of 1. That is equivalent to 2/9, always on the numerator side. Denominator is a support of 1, which is equivalent to 6 divided by 9, which is equivalent to 33.34%, less than 50%, invalid rule. Rule number 2, subset 2 to be considered, that is 2, tends to 1, 5. Support is same, but confidence in this case is support of 1 to 5 is 2/9 divided by support of 2, that is 2/9. 7/9 in this case, which is equivalent to 28.57%, less than 50%, invalid rule. Coming back to rule number 3, set is 5 subset and tends to 1, 2. The support is 22.22% again. The next one is the confidence, that is support of 1 to 5 divided by support of 5, which is equivalent to 2/9 divided by 2/9 in this case, because the item 5 was bought 2 times, which is equivalent to 100%. Which is greater than 50%, hence it is a valid rule. Coming back to fourth rule, 1, 2 is on the left side, the right hand side remaining is 5. Support is 22.22%, confidence is 2/9, that is the support of 1 to 5, divided by support of 1, 2. 1, 2 is bought 4 times, that is 4 divided by 9 in this case. 2/4, 50%, which is equivalent to 50%, hence it is a valid rule. Now coming back to the next one, that is the rule number 5. 5 tends to 2, support is 22.22%, confidence is support of 1 to 5 divided by support of 1, 5, which is equivalent to 2/9 divided by 2/9, because 1, 5 is bought 2 times, which is equivalent to 100%, greater than 50%, hence it is a valid rule. Coming back to the 6th rule, 2, 5 on the left hand side tends to 1, which is equivalent to 22.22%, and confidence in this case is support of 1 to 5 divided by support of 2, 5, which is equivalent to 2/9 divided by 2/9, 2/2, which is equivalent to 100%, because 100% is greater than 50%, it's a valid rule. So in this case, we found 4 valid rules, that is rule number 3, 4, and 4, 5. So this is the simple process with which you can apply the a priori algorithm to find the association rules for the given set of transactions in this case. I hope the concept is clear. If you like the video, do like and share with your friends. Press the subscribe button for more videos. Press the bell icon for regular updates.